Wait. Vogel, look sharp.
Thank you. something there, boy. Could that be our man? Are you all right?
Yeah. Dare say I'll survive. That griffin caught me before I could get an arrow off. Must have lost sight of me in the grass, though. I'd be dead if it hadn't.
More likely than not.
The name's Camille. I'm a lowly leather worker, if you couldn't tell by the smell of me.
Not so lowly from what I hear. Do you remember selling to a merchant by the name of Karen?
She's not an easy woman to forget. Bought a cuirass from me after I lost my buyer. Quite taken with my work, as far as I recall. Didn't stop her bartering me down to a pittance, though. She sent you for a refund.
It's not her who sent me.
Well, consider me flattered.
You should be. He's a master of his art, and not an easy man to impress.
Blacksmiths are proud folk. It's a rare thing indeed for one to praise a glorified tanner. And I don't imagine an impressive swordsman like yourself would be getting your steel from any but the best. I'd dearly love to help a fellow craftsman, but... Well, actually, I suppose you could give him this.
What is it?
Treated leather. Same stuff I used to make that cuirass. If your man's as skilled as he sounds, he'll know what he's looking at.
You sure?
Well, you did save my life. And thanks to you, I'll be going home with all the griffin hide I can carry. I'd say it's the least I can do. Short of showing him how to make the thing myself, that is. But there are rules against it. Secrets of the trade and whatnot.
In that case, I'll see that he gets it.
I'd be much obliged if you would. Right, I've got some greaves to make. You send your blacksmith my regards.
Will do. And thank you. Hopefully this will sweeten Blackthorn's mood.